Do you want to build a second brain? A personal reference system that you can refer to when you want to remember everything that you have learned? Let's get into it, shall we? What is up, YouTube? My name is Aiden Halfon. I am an upcoming freshman Cornell University student who makes videos on life advice as well as learning and fitness. Today, I'm going to be showing you my personal note-taking system. I use this system for storing everything that I learned for use in writing, scripts, blogs, and develop my reservoir of knowledge for any daily life task. Notion is basically a massive note-taking platform, but it's not just for note-taking. It's actually just pretty much for business preparation. You can make for whatever your needs are. That's what I really like about Notion is, unlike other systems where the general format is already put into place for you and you put your own things in and just write, Notion kind of makes you build your own site. It's actually really cool. So this is the main screen of my Notion page. As you can see, I have my journal, my life notes, the creativity complex, YouTube, blogging, my weekly review, and then my 5/25 goal list. If you want to see that video, by the way, I'll link it in the description. Every single one of these sections, it's actually kind of a part of my life. So as you can see with the journal section, I have my dream journal, short stories, story-worthy moments, and then just my normal journal in general. My normal journal changes all the time depending on what I want to learn at the moment, but I always, always like to have my highlight of the day at the top. That's just where I put what is the one thing that I really want to get done. If everything else doesn't get done on my to-do list, but I get that highlight of the day done, I'll be happy. Then I have, did I make time for the highlight? Most of the time it's yes, because that would kind of defeat the point. Now here's a really nice one that I like to have in there. The best thing I learned today. So this is really interesting because if I write down the best thing I learned from every single one of my days, it becomes really interesting when I go back through my journal and just look and read at all the things that I found to be the best thing that I learned that day. And then actually in my weekly review at the bottom, I have a best thing I learned in the week. Now that's really important because I get to go through all of my journals for the past week and choose which lesson I actually thought was the best out of all of them. Then I have two things that disturbed my tranquility today and why. This is kind of related to stoicism, and for those of you who don't know what stoicism, it's basically a philosophy on life that I really, really like, and I've been trying to learn more about the principles behind stoicism, and this is just one section where I can try and analyze why some things make me mad, why some things disturb my tranquility, so that I can better figure out how I can make them not disturb me in the future. Then I have three things I'm grateful for today. I think this is just fantastic for realizing that life is really not as bad as you think it is. If you put down three things you're grateful for every single day, you're gonna realize that you really don't have as many problems as you thought, and it's really gonna put you in a happy mindset at the end of the day. This is really nice to do right before you go to bed. Then this changes all the time. Because the journal is something that you're gonna look at every single day, I think it's actually really, really helpful to put some like flashcards or like toggle lists as in Notion. And that way, whenever you're going through your journal at the end of the day, you can try and remember what is under the thing. And that way you're kind of doing it like a flashcard. So right now I have the main Stoic principles, and this way I will get them in my mind for the future. And maybe when I'm learning about something else that's really interesting, I'll put something else in here for my journal. Then we have story-worthy moments. This is just where I look at my day and choose the most story-worthy moment that I think happened. This can be pretty much anything. It's different every single time, but I found that doing this has made me just remember every single day so much more, and time flows so much slower because every single part of my day, the days are not lived in isolation anymore, because I'm always looking for that one moment in a day that I could make into a story if I wanted to. And it just makes every day much more interesting. Then I have my dream journal. Fortunately, I have not been dreaming very much as of late, but when I did dream a lot more, I wrote down a lot more, but as you can see, a lot of the dates have been nothing, which is very sad. I would like to dream more. Big rip. Then I have my short stories. This is where I just write short stories based on my story-worthy moments as well as other things in my life. I'm hoping to flesh out these stories going forward so that I can actually kind of tell them at dinner table conversations or to friends or other people going forward. Going on to the life notes section is where I just choose any article or YouTube video, Skillshare class that I thought was very interesting. So I have it organized where I put the type of media that it is on the left here, and I'll either put Skillshare class, YouTube video, you know, podcast, anything like that. Then I'll put the name, I'll put the status, if I'm still listening to it, if I'm finished. Then I'll put the author and the publisher, and then finally the link, and most importantly, the category that the information is under. Now, it's very important to put the category, like learning, studying, habits, or goal setting, because that way, whenever I'm making a video on one of those topics, instead of like having to skim through all this stuff and just like be completely overwhelmed, I can just simply search up at the search bar here for whatever I'm looking for, and any video related to that topic will pop up. Next, I have my creativity complex. This is where I have all my book notes of any book that I've completely read. I don't put books here that I've only half finished if I didn't like them, and I separate them into nonfiction and fiction. I put my authors, the genre of the book, the date I finished it, the rating, five-star, you know, four-star, or life-changing, which has only been a few books, and then my note status. Now, what I like to do is, for fiction book, I actually got this template from Ali Abdaal. It was really, really nice. I have a section that makes me say what it's about, then I have how I discovered it, what I liked about it, what I didn't like about it, who else would like it, and then related books. So it's not that in-depth for fiction books, because fiction books for me, I read more just for enjoyment, not for actually learning a lot of stuff. I have learned stuff from fiction books, but I just enjoy reading them. Then for nonfiction books, there's two different things I do. If I thought it was 5-star or below, I will just write down what the book, a book summary in 3 sentences, how I discovered it, who should read it, how the book changed me, my top 3 quotes from the book, and then that's it. And usually that's enough for any book that's 5-star or below, because even though it probably was a quite good book, it wasn't good enough for me to actually go super in-depth and make a whole summary and notes section on it. Now, if the book was life-changing, like what do I have right here? Like Getting Things Done, that was an incredibly life-changing book for me. I will actually go through and write a summary and notes of the entire book. Now, sometimes if I'm feeling really, really productive, I will actually reread the book and make the notes myself. But oftentimes that would take way too long, even though I definitely should probably do that, because our own thoughts written down are a lot better than just copying and pasting from like a summary or something like that. What I do is I'll either go on a site like Blinkist or search up a book summary online, and then I'll go through and type out everything by hand instead of just copying and pasting the notes section. Because if I just copied and pasted, I wouldn't actually be relearning it. I would just be not doing anything. I'd just be copying and pasting some notes in. But if I have to write it all again, it's almost as if I read the book again. And because I've already read the book completely normally, it's actually still helpful just to copy everything down in this way. Then we have my video and blogging board. Once again, it's separated into ideas, cogs turning, which is if I really think I'm gonna make it into a video and I've started scripting it. Then we have actually scripted, then we have recorded, edited, and published. And this is the same in my blogging board. This just helps me organize my life, my blogging and YouTube career a little bit better. So wrapping up, this Notion has changed my life, guys. If you have never tried having like a second brain system or a place where you store what you've read and made notes on, you will not realize until you do how helpful it can be. Our brain is for having ideas, not for storing them. If we have all of our ideas stored in another note-taking system on things we've already read and like looked at, then we'll come up with ideas, more ideas than we ever know what to do with. I mean, the amount of YouTube ideas and blogging ideas that I've come up with after doing stuff like this, it's absolutely insane. You will never want to go back to storing everything in your head and being anxious all the time about what you have to do. So I urge you to try out Notion or some other note-taking system in the future. Thanks so much for watching, guys. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to like and subscribe, as well as hit the bell icon. If you want to see more of my content, just simply check out more of my videos on my channel. As always, I hope you have a fantastic day. Bye-bye.